This is our second demonstration involving fragments. Here, we set up fragments for modeling anti-ferromagnetic coupling in a ferredoxin compound. In this case, we will use some of the more advanced features in the Atom Groups Editor in order to specify the molecule's electronic structure. We've already opened the molecule, and we will reposition it within the view window in order to make it easier to define the fragments desired. The strategy here is to define four fragments, one for each iron atom and its attached groups, and one for each of the central sulfur atoms. Use the marquee selection tool to select one iron atom and its two attached groups. Then click on the plus button in the second row to assign those atoms to fragment 2. Repeat the process for the second iron atom and its attached groups, making them fragment 3. The last step is to define a fourth fragment consisting of one of the central sulfur atoms. In order to do so, we use the Group Actions button in the upper right corner of the dialog and add a fourth group. Accept the default name of fragment 4. We then add the sulfur atom closest to us to this group. Once we turn on highlighting, the four defined fragments are easily visible. We will now go on to use the remaining fields in the Atom Group Editor to specify the characteristics of the complex electronic configuration exhibited by this molecule. We will use the charge, multiplicity, and unpaired spin type columns in order to do so. Overall, this molecular system has a charge of -2 and is a singlet. However, each iron atom has 5 unpaired electrons. One iron atom will have 5 unpaired alpha electrons, and the other will have 5 unpaired beta electrons. Thus, fragments 2 and 3 are sextets with a charge of +1. The two single sulfur atom fragments each have a charge of -2 and a spin multiplicity of 1. Begin to specify these characteristics by setting the charge for each fragment. Notice how the number of electrons column is updated automatically as we make each change. Specifying a charge of +1 for fragments 2 and 3 has changed their spin multiplicity to a doublet. We will modify this to indicate that they are actually sextets. Finally, we specify the spin type for fragments 3 as beta. Before closing the dialog, turn on persistent visuals so we can continue to see the highlighting. When we open the Gaussian calculation setup window, we can see the overall fragment charge and spin multiplicity settings, which have been generated by examining the Gaussian route section at the top of the window. The molecule overall is a singlet with a charge -2, and the first and the fourth fragments have the same characteristics. The second fragment is a charge of +1 and a spin multiplicity of 6, while the third fragment has the same charge and a spin multiplicity of -6. A negative value here for the spin multiplicity is used to indicate beta unpaired electrons. We can now go on to set up the rest of the Gaussian calculation and then run it.